Welcome back to the biggest mistakes sellers make in a hot market. So last week I forgot my coffee. I did not make that same mistake again. I have it and we're ready to go. So this segment is for all you do-it-yourselfers. And this, of course, is going to be tackling the subject of for sale by owner. In a hot market, selling your house is easy, right? Well, let's just talk about it. And we're gonna start with a story. So this plant, I think, is from IKEA. If not, I have tons of IKEA stuff throughout my house. Who does not love IKEA, right? Well, my brother-in-law bought an entire kitchen worth of cabinets and he installed them. Now, during the process, we came by his house. He had cabinets, doors, screws, you name it, they were everywhere. Instructions galore. And when he was finished, I'm telling you, the kitchen looked amazing. However, he had experience with plumbing, electrical, he'd installed cabinets before, and he had renovated plenty of properties. So he could do it, and he could do it well. It made perfect sense for him to use IKEA cabinets. Well, now I'm gonna tell you another story. I feel like this is like a fairy tale or something, right? Okay. So this is another story, and this is the flip side, and it's literally regarding flips. My husband and I bought properties and started renovating them. Well, we thought we would do it ourselves and save money. We didn't hire a contractor. Instead, we hired individual subs to do the work. Well, what ended up happening is it took forever to get our property on the market. Sometimes we actually ended up paying more because we had to redo the repairs, and the quality control, it just wasn't as good. So after a while of realizing this was just not gonna work, we ended up using a contractor, and it made all the difference. So the moral of the story is if you have a background in interior design, marketing, maybe you're an attorney or you know real estate law, then a for sale by owner might be a good route to take. If not, do not try and sell your house on your own. It just doesn't make sense. Now, when we started this series, we wanted to come from a place of contribution and we wanted to be a resource for you. So we actually have a guide, and in that guide, it will cover things like the proper pricing and staging, attracting the buyers through effective marketing, negotiating and preparing the contract, and closing the transaction. We will cover all of these subjects and we'll actually give you some material. You can schedule a consultation online or you can go ahead and schedule it in person. But we want to make ourselves available to you if you are determined to sell on your own. So, in conclusion, you have two paths to take. If you have experience, go for it and we'll help provide resources for you. If you don't have experience, don't go it alone. Join us next week. We're going to be tackling one of my all-time favorite subjects. Thank you for joining us for the biggest mistakes sellers make in a hot market.